Maddie, this is so cool. What are we building today?
Today, we're going to be building the Light Up Infinity Mirror.
Very cool. So what was the inspiration behind this design? So
I've always been really inspired by infinity mirrors, something that's so shallow looking from the side, but as soon as you're facing it head on is this endless illusion in front of you. And the ones I had seen out there always seemed to be more in installations where I wanted to create something that was more engaging and something you could actively play with. So I included some motion in this one.
Very cool. All right, I'm really looking forward. Can you show me how it comes together?
Yeah, let's do it. I just need a crate. Perfect. All right, it's time to build. Let's start by assembling the mirror. First, peel off the film from your mirror. Now, flip it over, place on the gear, and the screw. It's okay if it's a little wiggly for now. Now, place the piece into the center ring. Now, place this yellow gear right here. Repeats our first stop and check. Make sure this yellow gear is lined up right along the middle. Now we're going to place on this blue disc. And then you should press down in the center and you'll hear them pop into place. Now we'll take two screws and screw one in on either side until tight. At this point, if you turn the big gear, the other two small ones should turn too. Now flip the piece over so the mirror side should now be facing up. Then we're gonna grab this leg and attach it onto this side, taking a screw and screwing it in between those two holes. And then grabbing our wood multi-tool to help get it all the way until you feel it's getting tight. Flip it over and add a nut on the back. Now repeat step 5 on the other side, making sure we grab this L-shaped leg, putting it on the side, screwing the screw in from the top, just like how we did before. And just when it's starting to get tight, you can flip it over and add a nut on the back. Another stop and check. Now, let's make sure that when the mirror is facing up, both legs are pointing down. Next, grab your two-way mirror and peel off the film on both sides. Now, twist a post through here until it starts to feel tight. Now, we're gonna attach the two-way mirror to that piece we built before, poking this post through the hole and flipping it over to screw a nut on the back. Awesome, you just assembled the mirror. All right, let's move on to part B. You're gonna build the base and the drawer. First, you're gonna press the gear onto the motor. You may need to press down a little hard. Stop and check again. This part can be a little tricky. Let's make sure that orange gear is pressed all the way onto that motor. To double check, you can also flip it over and press it down onto a table. Now we're gonna connect the motor onto this wooden base. First, we'll place it on top and then poke two screws through the holes. Next, we're gonna flip it over and screw on two nuts on the back. Now, we're gonna grab two of these wooden pieces and attach one with the long cutout facing this direction through this slot here. And then doing the same on the other side with that slot facing forward. Now, to attach the button, we're gonna thread these wires through the hole in the wood and flip it over, threading this metal ring through and screwing it on the back. Let's clip two yellow clips onto the side. This slot and this one. If you need to remove a clip, try squeezing these two tabs on the bottom and you should be able to pop it out and back in again. Now we're gonna place this wooden piece onto the larger build, first making sure that this straight edge is facing up and lining up these clips with the slots on the side. And go ahead and clicking them into place until they snap in. You might have to wiggle it into place. Make sure when clipping these in that the wood edges meet flat, just like this. Now let's poke these wires through the hole one at a time. Until they're both back like this. Now let's connect the yellow wires. Make sure to hold them by the connectors when attaching them and don't pull too hard, otherwise they could break. Next, let's attach the clips onto this wood piece. Clips are so satisfying. Now let's attach this piece onto the base. For this one, we're gonna wanna make sure these two wooden tabs are going into these slots and that the two clips are lining up into these just like they did at the front. So first, I'm gonna line up one clip and the other, and then I'm going to make sure those slots are in place. And then you might have to do a little bit of wiggling again with the clips to make sure everything's sitting flat. Stop and check. Before moving forward, let's make sure that your build matches what we have here. The orange gear should be facing forward, and the straight edge of this wood panel should be facing forward as well. Also, let's make sure each of the tabs from these clips are firmly into the holes from the slots. Let's grab this cable and thread it through this hole on the back. First, we're gonna take the blue wire coming off the cable and connect it onto this blue wire from the motor. Make sure to press until you hear it click into place. Next, we're gonna grab one of these red wires. Either one works. Connect it to the red wire coming off of the button. And press to click. You're still gonna have one red and one black wire remaining. Now, let's connect these two pieces together by slotting them together. We'll add this yellow nut back here, and pop it in, and then this blue screw screws in from the side. There'll be a small gap left here, and that's okay. We're gonna use that later. Now, let's connect this piece through these slots. Put it in like this, and if you're finding it a little difficult to put in, you can also slightly unscrew the screw to wiggle it into place, and then screw it back on. Now let's repeat steps 12 to 13. We're gonna slide this wooden part onto the side, add the yellow nut onto the back, pressing it into the slot, and then this blue screw screws in from the side, just like before. Now let's attach this front of the drawer onto the slots on either side, just like we did with those yellow clips from before, popping them into place until you see the KiwiCo logo on top. You just built the drawer and base for your mirror. Now set the mirror base onto the wooden base. The legs should sit inside, just like this. This part can be tricky, so you might have to ask a friend to help hold things in place. Next, we're gonna line up this hole in the wood so it pokes through that hole in the leg. We're going to take this blue bracket, making sure that the long line is pointing up, and poke it right through that hole in the wood until it notches into place as you grab this little screw and screw it in from the side. Let's do the other side, lining up this leg of the mirror with the hole in the wood, grabbing our other blue bracket, slotting that right into place, and finally, grabbing this green screw and screwing that until it's tight. Next, we're gonna poke these wires through the same hole in that blue piece, doing them one at a time, the black one and then the red one. Now, let's tilt up the mirror and slide down the piece right over the brackets. Now, put the drawer right into these slots. And then you can open it up and store little things in there anytime you want. Now let's connect the wires. First, red to red. And now black to black. Next, let's add these clips onto the wooden piece. One side. other. Let's add the piece onto the back. You should hear a click on this side and over here. Now let's turn the mirror around. Before turning it on, let's add some wiggly eyes. Now you should be able to plug your mirror into any USB device at home. Taking the end of that cable, plugging it in, and you'll see the lights come on right away. As another test, you can press the button and you'll see the motor turn on also. Don't forget to unplug your mirror as soon as you're done. You don't want to leave electronics plugged in unattended overnight. So if both the lights and the motor don't turn on, which is crucial, check out the USB device you're plugged into. You might have to swap out your USB power adapter, like this. Or make sure that your power strip is plugged into the wall and turned on. Finally, you could also make sure your power bank or other device you're charging on is powered. Next, if either the lights don't turn on or the motor doesn't spin, let's go ahead and check each of these wire connections and make sure they are firmly connected and to the right color. Red to red, blue to blue, black to black, and yellow to yellow. Now, if the motor spins but the mirror doesn't, let's go ahead and check that all of these gears are meshing together and that the orange gear is firmly placed onto that motor. Finally, let's check that all of these wires are tucked to the side just like they are here and not getting in the way of that gear. If the mirror doesn't easily move between standing up and lying down, let's go ahead and double check that both of these legs are facing in this direction. Next, let's take another look at these blue brackets and make sure that the screws on either side are tightly screwed on. If you're still having a hard time, head back to Part C, Steps 2 and 3, and make sure those brackets are fitting snugly into these holes in the base. If you're finding any fingerprints on the mirror, you can grab any microfiber cloth from home and get rid of them.
Wow, the build came out great, but I know there's a next step to this.
Yes, the fun part. Let's do it. So to start, you get this bead ring and a bunch of different colored beads to choose from. So you go ahead and start threading them on one by one. I'm gonna try a rainbow. So now that we've put all our beads on the ring, let me show you how we place it into the mirror. First, we're going to lift up the mirror and fold it back towards us, and then swivel open the semi-transparent front mirror and place the bead ring right in there. Now, we're able to swivel that two-way mirror closed and set it up front.
Can I spin it?
Go for it.
Whoa, that is so cool. It really takes it to the next level.
Want to see another illusion?
Of course.
So this one is called Dizzying Discs. You're gonna grab any two from the collection here. I'm gonna start with these two. Okay. And then you're also gonna grab these sticky dots. You'll take the front cover off and then be able to pick that one right up and place it right in the center of the first one. And for this next one, I'm gonna stick that one directly on the mirror and put it up here. And then for extra stability, put it down here. And now to attach them, I'm going to lift up that mirror again and fold it back. And this time when we swivel it open, we're going to be attaching this front disc right on the mirror and lightly press on those sticky dots just to make sure it's secure. And then next, I will grab the top disc and place it right in the middle in the opposite orientation than the one on the bottom. So we'll swivel it back on, put it right in the position.
I'm just gonna stare at this for the next few hours. You wanna come back?
Perfect.
All right, so when I was prepping for this video, you told me to send you a picture of my cat, which I did. Can we see why?
Definitely. So here we have my cat Lola and your cat Kiki. And let's see how we can use them to help customize our mirror. We're gonna grab two more of our sticky dots and place them right in the back. I'll let you position Kiki.
Oh, okay. Wait, we have to, like here, what do you think?
I love it.
Okay.
Let's do it. Close it. put it back in the standing position and see what it does.
All right, cat tornado. I would love to think that this is how it would go if our cats actually met.
We actually have one more game you can play with this. If you look in your crate, you'll see this. I won't spoil it for anyone who has the crate at home though. But if you put these up to the mirror and you hold them up, you'll see the words reflected on the mirror to become readable.
That's super cool. This is definitely gonna live on my desk with the pictures of our cats, of course. I love the illusion and all the thought you put into it. Can you talk to me a little bit more about how it really works?
Yeah, definitely. So it may look like an infinitely long tunnel, but it's not. We have two mirrors actually here. The back one is just your standard normal mirror, and that front one is a see-through two-way mirror with the lights sandwiched right in the middle. The effect happens because the beam of light is bouncing back and forth between those two mirrors, creating smaller and smaller reflections. And because those reflections get smaller and smaller, it looks like a tunnel, just getting longer and longer. In reality, even the shiniest mirror doesn't reflect 100% of the light that hits it. So each reflection gets slightly dimmer and dimmer until the effect disappears.
So these two mirrors reflecting off of each other are creating the illusion, but how are we actually able to see the illusion? Like, how am I able to see through a mirror?
Yeah, good question. So this back mirror is like your standard normal mirror at home. It's gonna be a piece of metal, and on top of that, a piece of glass. Usually metal, something like aluminum. And this front mirror is actually a two-way mirror, so you can somewhat see through it, and that's because it also has a metal coating, but does not include as much metal. So you're able to see through and see what the effect is inside.
Oh, cool. Maddie, thank you so much for showing this to me. It's super cool. Definitely gonna live on my desk. Thanks so much for watching. To see more videos like this, make sure to subscribe to KiwiCo. Swirl in. If I went like.
We just need a crate.
Oh, I forgot. I thought we were doing the same thing as last time. Oh no. Oh, ah! Oh. I don't know where that bead went. All right, let's see it. Oh no!
Absolutely.
All right, thank you. See.